I am Mo2Zano, the Tabletop Bellhop, your cardboard concierge, working with you to make your game nights better. Now, tonight, what I want to let you know and help you out with is to know if you should pick this up. So, first off, this is an expansion for Endangered, the game Endangered. So, main thing is, if you don't have Endangered and you don't know what Endangered is, check out our review right now, then go buy it, because it is one of the best cooperative games I've ever played. I adore Endangered. The base game comes with tigers and otters, and I love it. Now, full disclosure, our podcast is sponsored by Grand Gamers Guild. Before that, though, we got a review copy of Endangered. Before we put out our review, before we were sponsored, we got that game. So take with that as you will, do what you will with that information. But yes, this is from our sponsor, Grand Gamers Guild, and this is a review copy. Endangered still rocks. It rocked before Mark was a sponsor. So it's just a good game. And literally one of my favorite games. Now, what this does is it expands it. It gives you new species, because in the base game of Endangered, you get tigers and otters. And we also checked out the butterfly expansion, which is a really cool promo one. Well, this has new ones. So we're going to open this up, see what you get. I'm expecting some really awesome animeeples and a bunch of cards, but I haven't actually checked it out. So let's open it up. All right, here you have the box for Endangered New Species. You need Endangered. It's right up here. It's a nice black warning. We're going to show off the sides quick. All right, that's thumpy. Here's the back. Look at all this. That's a lot of species. But let's check it out this way. Oh, it doesn't want it. There it goes. Bag of baggies. Always appreciate. Quite a bit of air in this box, I gotta admit. Impact cards. Everything's just kind of in here loose. Animeeples are the coolest part. New species. So we're going to look at this first. So general rules. Interesting. Use your relevant. Destruction tiles are double-sided with different things. Make sure you're using the right ones. Looks cool. So not a lot of rules. Okay, so what we have, we're going to go through it. What do we have? We have sea turtles. Well, that's on the cover of the box, so I expected that one. They have their own setup, offspring, destruction rules, and difficulty settings. Oh, this is it? Okay. So this is instead, so in the base game, there's like cardboard cards that fold out that have this info. Instead, it's in a book. Polar bears. Polar bear scenario. California condor scenario. That's got an interesting setup. Elephant scenario. Wow, you start with a lot of elephants. Oh, okay. This is interesting. There's difficulty levels. Sea turtles are easy, normal, hard. Polar bears are normal, hard, and critical. And same thing with condors and elephants. Okay, so there's a bit of a difficulty thing. Devil's Hole Pupfish scenario. And then the Jaguar and Tapir scenario. So two different animals on the same one. I wonder if they're hunting each other. You got a predator-prey thing going on there. Cool. And, oh, some changes. There's a variant here. And some new ambassadors. Okay, cool. So it's not just new species. You've got the policy change variant. You've got new ambassadors and new specialties for some of the characters. Cool to know. Didn't know those were in here at all. I knew there were scenarios. How many scenarios do we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Wow. The base game only comes with 2. You get 6 scenarios in here. That's impressive. All right. Well, I don't even know where to start here with all this stuff. Let's go with meeples. No. We're gonna dump the punch board here first. So, devastation tiles, a tracker. These are the variants for that variant rule, whatever it is, the policy change rules. And then the back of the devastation tiles are different. So, you're going to have a different set of devastation tiles. Looks like farmland moving in. This, I know, is specifically for the polar bears. If I remember, maybe I'm wrong. Yeah, polar bear scenario, this is used. So some kind of special devastation. And more devastation. So, okay. What's shocking is, like, whatever scenario this is only uses 6 devastation tiles. Oh, no, there's more on this side. Okay. Oh, weird. Okay, they did a weird thing with some different types. It's not, like, the same stuff on both sides. I All right. We're going to do cards because I want to show it to people. Oh, here's the new. Okay. We're going to do these first. So here are the new specialties for the different the character classes in the base game. And I'm assuming these are two-sided. So the celebrity now can give back to the fans. Environmental lawyer gets negotiation. Lobbyist gets foot in the door. Philanthropist gets angel investment. TV wildlife host gets filming permits. Zoologist gets natural selection. They are a single-sided, so one new ability to choose for each of the characters. This I am looking forward to, honestly, because after quite a few plays of Endangered, we got to know which cards were in the deck pretty easily, and there were definitely certain ones we tended to lean towards rather than other ones. And yes, there's nice new, a whole bunch of new blues, a new green, and a new purple. So that should mix things up. I really appreciate this one. That's cool. Something about this card pile. So we have Australia, Bangladesh, the United Kingdom, Peru, Ethiopia, and Pakistan. Interestingly, this says special. Oh, that's neat. Actually, I like it. So you get one die per, I forget the term, influence cube that's on here. And they vote yes if you roll a 5 or 6 on any of them. So the more cubes you have, the better your chances. But you could put 80 cubes there and still fail. That's interesting. Okay, these are going to be the various impact decks. Kind of all mixed together. I can already tell. So, polar bear cards. We're just going to flip through these. Art's nice, just as it was in the base game. You're going to have various instant impacts, a lot of the same. Oil spills, terrible things, hunting, all the bad things and good things that can happen. So you got a polar bear deck, and it just says impact, polar bear. We're going to do these quick because sea turtles with great looking pictures of sea turtles, as well as other nice hand-drawn artwork. Devil's Hole Pupfish. That is one I'd have to do a bit of research on. Just part of why this game is good, because it can bring to light endangered species you may not be aware of. Tapir and Jaguar. Elephant. The art's consistent too, which is good to see. And the condor. There you go. 6 new decks. Animeeple time. Animeeple time. Turtles. Silkscreen turtles. It's awesome. Only on one side, but so what? Bunch of turtles. Elephants. They are two-sided. It's cool because you're going to stand them up, right? Turtles are going to lay flat. Smart. Jaguar. Oh, I like the spotting. It's, unfortunately, my camera's not picking it up very well, but they have spots. Tapirs. Tiny. Tapirs are tiny. Holy cow. Tapir. Oh, they even have like a pattern on them. They're so tiny. Tapir. Okay, I'm confused. Are there baby tapirs? I think they're baby tapirs. I think there's two sizes. Because otherwise, cool. Polar bears. Yeah, those have got to be baby tapirs. Polar bears aren't silkscreened. Could have added an eye dot, maybe. Pupfish. Two-sided. Okay, it's really odd that the turtles aren't two-sided now. Because the pupfish are. Oh, I guess these could stand up. And last, the condor. Look at that. Of course, that one's not. Odd, random, what's two side and what's not. Still cool. Silkscreen on any side is awesome. Six new scenarios. That's a lot. That's a lot of new gameplay for one of my favorite cooperative games of all time. All right. Now we can fast forward and get to the end. There it is. There you have what you get in the box for Endangered New Species, an expansion for Endangered. Grand Gamers Guild, a fantastic cooperative game with a great dice placement mechanism where every different species features its own rules and makes it a unique game. We've tried three different species ourselves, enjoyed them all. Check out our review for information on it. Really looking to check out six new scenarios in here. Six brand new scenarios, including awesome looking animeeples. Most of them silkscreen, look fantastic. New policy change cards, or what do we call them? Sorry, a policy change variant. There was a new set of variant rules, new special powers for each of the roles, and new UN members for the game that can probably be, I would assume, be able to use with the base scenarios as well. This looks really fantastic. The only thing I'm a little disappointed in is that they just put the species scenario rules in a book, where in the original game there were nice folders, and even in the Butterfly expansion, it's a nice little cardboard folder. We lost that somehow. Fair enough. This is probably cheaper. I get it. If you're saving, if as long as that savings got passed on to the customer, I'm all for it. There you go. My first thoughts on Endangered New Species. So I would say we're going to review this one soon, but it's going to take us a while to play through six new scenarios. Especially if we try to play a couple of them more than once, just to make sure we get the full effect. So eventually we'll be talking about Endangered on the Tabletop Bellhop Gaming Podcast, which you can find on your podcatcher of choice. You can take a listen right now over at tabletopbellhop.com. Check out our show notes for our most recent episodes. Thank you for joining me for this unboxing video. I am Mo Tuzano, the Tabletop Bellhop. Good day and game on.